Okay, now we are going to touch some more confusing part. Okay, rules. This one is something new. It's not the same as the elementary algebra. This is specifically valid for Boolean algebra. We have many of them. Okay, we have 12 of them. Okay, a little bit of bad news. You have to remember up to here. Okay, because they are simple, they are basic rules. We are going to use it many times, so it's better to remember them. From first 9, you have to remember, and 10, 11, and 12, you don't have to remember, because they can be derived from the first 9. Okay, by using some of them, you can get the answer from there. Okay. All right. So now them are very fundamental, and totally we have 12 rules. We are going to go through them one by one. Rule number one. Okay. So how do we do that? How do we verify this rule is valid? Okay. A plus 0 equal to A. Okay, this one seems simple, right? Seems the same as elementary algebra. Variable plus nothing equal to itself. Okay, and this is the most simple one. Let's think about how to verified, tested is correct. As we mentioned, A is a Boolean variable, digital variable, only has two possibilities. Okay, that's simple. We just try one by one. If they all valid, we can say this is correct. Okay. So let's do first one. If A equal to 1, this come to 1 plus 0, which is 1 plus 0, output should be 1. Okay, that's clear. How about this one? If A equal to 0, 0 plus 0 equal to 0. Okay, and output is 1 and 0. So how do we summarize this equation? This one is equal to the input variable, okay, 1 to 1 and 0 to 0. Seems like we just pass through the variable from input to output, so output will be the variable itself. Okay, so this is basic procedure with how do we test the results is correct or not. All right, is it clear? Right. First one always simple. I think about second one. Rule number two. A plus 1 equal to 1. This one seems very strange. Right? A plus 1, y is equal to 1. Okay. Again, let's try two possibilities. 0 and 1. Okay. If it's 1, 1 plus 1 equal to 1. If it's 0, 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Okay, seems output will be always equal to 1. Okay, doesn't matter the input variables change. So just the equal to 1. That's interesting, right? So it's easy to test, right? So doesn't matter its value, output will be always 1. Okay, I remember whenever we see plus 1, output just 1, doesn't matter these variables conditions. All right, let's go to the third one. A times 0 equal to 0. Okay, this one seems same as elementary algebra. Okay, same thing, two possibilities. Okay, 1, 0, output will be always 0, That's why we can get 0. Okay, any questions so far? Okay, seems good. let's do the next one. A times 1 equal to the A. Okay, same thing. It's variables 0, 1. As long as we see 0, output will be 0. And 2 ones times together, we can get 1. Okay. And this one, same thing. Input variables value directly transferred to the output. 0 to 0, 1 to 1, so will be the variable itself. Okay. Next one. Okay. Let's go a little bit quicker. A plus A equal to A. Okay. Seems we can simplify the variable. 2A sum together equal to A. Alright. If A equals 0, 0 or 0 will be equal to 0. If variable equal to 1, 1 or 1 equal to 1, okay, 1 will be equal to this input variable, output 0 equal to the input variable, okay? So input variable just directly transfer from input to output with no change, so it will be just A. Are you okay? So many rules. Okay, next one. Interesting. Okay. Interesting. Okay, just so many rules. I think we need to go through one by one, and most importantly, you need to do your more practice. Okay. Later on you can do some homework to do some more practice and do some calculations on paper by yourself. Okay, more practice will be helping you to understand. Okay, A plus not A or A bar equal to 1. That's interesting. Okay, they are just opposite. If A is 1, 1 plus 0 equal to 1. If A is 0, 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Okay, so which means it's always 1. Okay, so many, almost there. There are something better to symbolize and an OR case. Similarity, what do you mean? You mean the symbol, okay? Both looks extremely similar when drawing nodes. Oh, you mean and the OR gate. Okay. We have another drawing, right? A square shape. Maybe you check the chapter 3 and we have square shape, and inside we have and or all letter there. Okay, you check the lecture notes in chapter 3. Okay, at the beginning we introduced them. Okay, yeah, that's a good question. Because it's not easy to draw this curve. Okay. All right. So next one is a times a equal to a. It's not a square, just 1a. Okay, same thing. Test two of them, 0, 0, output to be 0, 1, 1, maybe 1, will be itself. Okay. Rule number 8. Okay, almost there. Okay, we have 9 rules. A times not A equals 0. Okay, same thing. The test is just opposite. As long as we can see 1, 0, output will be 0. So, which means we guaranteed we can see at least 1, 0 in the input, so output will be 0. Okay. Okay, rule number 9 is most simple one. Okay. not A will be A. Okay, so just flip and flip back. So it will be easy. And in level one, we are doing 6 times, okay, flipping. Okay, we have 6 not gate together. Finally, we should be go back to the initial one. Okay. All right. Congratulations. We finished the 9 basic one. And this 9 rules, you should be able to remember because we use them many, many times and they are very useful. Okay. To design our circuits, to simplify our circuits. Okay. And the rule number 10. You don't have to remember. If you can remember, it will be better. Actually, this one can be derived from the 9 rules. How can we do that? Okay, that's a little bit tricky. We can use this one as a practice. Okay, example. A times 0, A times 1. Well, 8 times 0, Thomas. Okay, let's do it together. So, let's write down here. A plus A B. Okay. A should equal to A times 1. Okay, so this is which rule? This is rule number 4, right? A times 1 equal to A. Go backwards. A should be equal to A times 1. All right, go back. Okay, and plus A times B. All right. And we just put A to the outside. What's the loss name? Distributive loss, right? And we have A, 1 plus B. 1 plus a variable equal to what? 1 plus a variable, try to remember. Which is, what is it? This one, equal to 1, right? Okay, that's it. Interesting. Okay, so 1 plus a variable equal to 1. So this one equal to A times 1. Okay, A times 1. Okay, this one come back to A. Okay, then we finish. That's interesting, right? So the conclusion is a variable plus this variable times another any variable. We can just remove this one. Okay. Then just the variable itself. So this is rule number 10. Okay, 2 more to go. Rule number 11 and rule number 12. Okay, I just put it here, just give you some more convenience. All right, so A times, yes, that's good. Leo, yes, A times anything. Okay, which is equal to itself. Okay, that's good. And think about this one. How can we do this one? Okay, let's do it together. Can we use this one? Number 10, A equal to A plus the product. Okay, it's just the it's bound this A to A plus A B. OK, Okay, then the rest will be this one, this one. Can you follow? What was the bar above the letter means is a complement, just an inversion. Okay, to invert the values from 1 to 0, 0 to 1. Okay, called not A. Alright, so we just use number 10 this way. A equal to A plus AB will be this one. Okay, this one just follow it. Then what do we do? We keep A no change, and I will put the second one and third one together. And we just put a B to the outside. Right? So how about here? Which rule? This one, right? Rule number 6. A plus not B equal to 1. And this one will be 1. Okay. So A plus B. That's it. Yes, a bar means invert. Okay. So now we finish this one. Rule number 11. Okay. I think you the first time you touch this concept sometimes it's just confusing and cannot remember. So again, you need more practice. Okay. How about the last one? First one, maybe I give you 1 minute. You try to do it by yourself. Okay. So we need some more practice. Just give you some hint. Try to use some rules and from here, from 1 to 9, pick up the rules you need. You need to break out the bracket. Okay. Just break out the bracket. Just high school math, right? And you will have more sum together and try to use some rules and laws. Okay. All right, 1 minute. Then we can do it together. So why we need 1 minute? Just give you some practice. Okay, don't just follow me. Okay, don't you will get lost. Try to grab a pen and a paper, try to do it. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, don't do a square. Okay, A times A, use rule number 7. Yeah, that's why you need your own practice. Just gets you to the new algebra. You will see the new algebra has some beauty there. We can easily to simplify some more complex equation. All right, let's do it together. So just break out the bracket. So this one will be A times A, and this one go to here. Okay, A times C, and B will be B times A plus B times C. Okay, can you follow so far? How annoying to realize just skipping the page. Okay. All right, let's think about how to simplify more after this. How about this one? Which rule? Rule number 7. Okay. So A times A should equal to A. Alright, then we just copy others here. Okay, do it step by step. Okay, B, C. Okay, some students already finished. Okay, that's so quick, that's good. And how about this one? Think about this rule. Yeah, rule number 10. Yes, good. So rule number 10 tells us variable plus variable times another variable. Okay, equal to the variable itself. Another variable could be anything. Okay, don't have to be B. B is just a variable, can be anything. Could be C, could be D. Right? So this one equals A. That's interesting. Okay, we remove this guy. How about we just do step by step. Okay. Now how about this one? Which rule? Okay, no idea. Which rule we need to apply? Equal to A. Yes, answer is correct. Rule number 10. Yeah, we use rule number 10 again. Variable is here now. Variable plus variable times another variable. This time another variable is B. Okay, that's interesting. Okay, A again. We remove another one. Okay, and the rest will be B, C. Okay, that's it. Yeah, B A equal to A B. Yeah, this is what's the name? Distributive law. Right? We just introduced the law. Right? Yes. Any questions? We'll finish this part. It's a rule number 12. Okay. Rule number 12, we finish. Rule number 11, finish. Okay. So again, you're supposed to remember up to here. Okay. Others, we can just derive. Okay. Apologize to many rules. Okay. Not my fault, your bullying's fault. Bullying discovered this many rules, but these rules are really useful. Later you will see, we can simplify very, very large circuit to very, very simple circuit, okay? By using Boolean's algebra to remove something, then we can make it very simple, okay? You can see here, for example, we have this much more complex equation. We can simplify it to a very simple one. Okay. All right, any questions?